Hello again, fellow gaming fans, and welcome back to my corner of the ARK. I'm Small Archangel, and welcome to this episode. So, what's been going on since my last episode? Well, quite a bit, really. A lot of the usual grinding, of course, but I have made some teeny-weeny changes, which reflect the stage we're at in the game, really. For example, I've added a couple of more small crop plots so that I could make, grow tintoberry seed and a stimberry seed. You can see they're both middlings now. And I did that for the same reason as I did the azoles and the majos here, which is that there are some very useful recipes which involve such berries, and therefore having the ability to grow those and grab them whenever you need a bunch is very good, very useful. Okay, so apart from that, I have, you can probably see, changed the wall around the base as well, or rather I have added to it. I have made it now 3 blocks high instead of just 2, which means it's nearly as high as the actual gateway. This means that dinos can't see me on the other side of it, never mind jump over it like some of the longer legged ones have done in the past. Also, you can see very easily where I accidentally put some of them the wrong way around. The reason I've got those 2 little windows there is because I'm kind of thinking at some point I might decide to put a walkway in there so that I can kind of go up and have a peer through my windows and see that it's safe outside before I venture out, because at the moment I honestly can't tell. That's the downside of having a really tall wall around the base, is I really can't see what's going on the outside. Now, it's been a while since I did the last episode, and I've got to tell you that I have been thinking seriously about whether to consider this series, whether to continue this series or not, because this game, as I've said before, is extremely hard work if you're a single player, which of course I am. If you've got a tribe, I think it's a different thing altogether. I think it's probably a better experience in some ways if you've got some good people to play with. So I've got to be honest with you that recently I've been wondering whether it was worthwhile continuing this series, and whether I should just take it off my active playlist, because it's, as I've said before, it's such hard work to play this game single player, and it requires so much grinding in between episodes, because I don't want to include those in my episodes. Obviously I want to just include the interesting stuff, but that seems like few and far between compared to, you know, the amount of resource grinding things I've had to do. So I decided on a compromise. We'll see how that goes for the time being. But basically, what I decided to do was to change the settings. I discovered the settings in the start menu, which if you're an admin on a server, or if like me you run your own server and it's just you on it, then you have the ability to change those. It never occurred to me to do that before, but I decided that might be a good idea. Okay, so basically these are all the sliders here, and of course I've known they were here forever since I started playing, but I've never really messed with them. And so I've got them all, pretty much, apart from these, and I don't know why they're different, but mostly they're on the default value of a 1.0. I basically haven't changed those, because it's never really occurred to me to change them, and yeah, I noticed them, but in my opinion it's kind of cheating to boost those up. So I've left them all at the default values. However, given that I'm playing this game on my own, and given that I'm trying to do a video series, and I'm finding this really difficult because this game is hard when you're playing single player, I think that actually it is justified to change these. I'm not going to change them all. I like the rest of them as they are, but we are going to try putting, doubling our harvest amount, just to see what that happens. It might be just insane, and I might end up with just too much stuff, and it might just make it completely no point whatsoever, in which case I shall adjust downwards again. But I'll just stick with the whole numbers for the time being. So this means, I assume, that we'll get twice what we would have got out of harvesting before, which is great, because that means we're going to spend a lot less time, a lot less time grinding for resources, so we'll see how we roll with that. So there you go, that's basically what I've done, and so now we should have double the resources whenever we try harvesting anything at all, which should very much help. And it does seem to work, because I have been trying it out, and well, one of the things that will prove it really, I suppose, is the fact that I've got more than this. I've actually got 2 full stacks of pelt plus 28. It's taken me a fair few, 96, day 96 now, it's taken me a fair few trips into the frozen wastes in order to get that much, in order to build myself a full set of fur armour. But that is what we're going to do today, so that we're better equipped to deal with the harsh conditions of the frozen biome. The other thing that I want to do actually is make a water jar. I need to make another couple of water jars. Here we go. We hide crystal and cementing paste. Okay, well, we've got crystal here. And we've got... Ooh, I thought we had hide here. I've got a shed load of hides over here. And I haven't gathered all this together first. Naughty me, but there you go. There's just so many things I want to make today. I didn't really want to start out with a full inventory. And we've got cementing paste in here. So there we go. So now we should be able to make a couple more. And I just want to make 2, really. And that's probably going to use up my cementing paste. Or else my crystal. No, it's going to use up my cementing paste. That's fine. Okay, that's cool. Okay, so we can put that back now. So I think we've got enough hide over at our workbench to be able to make the other things that I want to make today. So we're having a bit of a crafting spree to start with, just because we can. So I've got a couple of water jars there. Now, one of the things I wanted to try making today was, I've got some tinted berries in here. I wanted to try making some healing potions, because I haven't had a chance to do that yet. Now, as far as I'm aware, and these are going to help us out a lot in our frozen biome there. Now, I've got a couple of spare water jars there, but we're just going to use this one for the time being. And we need tinto berries, and we also need a couple of narcotics. I think it's 2 narcotics, but I'm not absolutely sure. And then if we light that, and then I've got, as I say, a couple of spare water jars here, which I'm going to put in my spare gear cupboard. Is that the one I mean? Yeah, that'll do for now. Almost do with more sort of cupboard space now. And I don't know how many points of health it's going to restore, because I haven't, this is the first time I've made one. So I haven't got the faintest idea how many points of health it's going to restore, or how many of these I should probably make. There we go, medical brew. Okay, so we'll put out the fire. And it's going to take, yeah, it's going to give me, and that spoils in like a day as well, so we don't want to make shed loads of those anyway. And it doesn't say, promotes healing, doesn't actually say how much exactly it's going to replace. So we'll just make that one for the moment, and we'll see how we do. Let's see, do I need to eat? Not really, really. Well, I should pop that there for the time being, so I can when I do need to. So that's one thing I wanted to do. There are other things you can make as well. You can make a sort of a stimulant for, you know, regaining your stamina and things too. But for the time being, we're going to get on and make our pelt armour. Now I've got, as you can see, another load of pelt there. So the thing we should probably do first, actually, is get our Engram points, because I've actually leveled twice since the last video, which is great. This is what killing mammoths does for you. We've got 50 points to spend now. Obviously, most of those points, or quite a lot of them, are going to be consumed in learning how to make the rest of our fur armor. Currently, I know how to make the boots and the gloves, and I have not learned the other parts. Now this, I need to learn the hide hat before we can make that also. So let's just learn the engrams for those two, and then that is actually going to have to wait, because at the moment, see how quickly they disappear, we need to learn this, but then we've only got 9 points left, and we need 14 for the fur hat. So, and I haven't actually looked at here to see if what other cool recipes might have been unlocked since our last pass. So obviously we've got a shield and sword, which I kind of am tempted to learn some of those. But the other thing we've got coming up a lot more now, got ghillie leggings. Okay, I'm not sure. Well, this is organic polymer, causes it to disperse heat. Oh, so these are keeping your cool ones okay. So I don't have too much of a problem with that at the moment, really. And we've got a lot of metal recipes coming out as well here. Shotgun ammo and things. I've never been too much of a gun toter in games, so I'm probably not going to worry about that too much. But I do quite fancy a go with a sword and shield. That seems quite fun to me. But we've got stone recipes and metal recipes, which would be quite nice to experiment with building some more bases like that. So just put the pelt in there. Now we've got hide, we've got fiber, and so we should have what we need to make these other bits of fur armor. Now at the moment I've got my gloves there, and I'm hoping I'm going to have a bit of pelt left over, because we are going to need to be able to repair our stuff as well. So first of all I'm going to make, no we don't want to make craft 8 pairs, how gutted would you be? So that's one pair of boots, and we'll make a pair of leggings. No, I don't want a pair, 3 of them, that would be ridiculous. And where are they there? And our chest as well. And I think if we had enough to unlock the hat recipe, we would probably have enough materials for that too. We've still got 204 there, which is quite cool. That's actually going to take 4 pelt to repair, and I'm not sure if the amount that it takes to repair goes down or up, but I'm not entirely sure it does actually. I think it just costs 4 to repair no matter what, which is a bit sucky really, so you're better off leaving it until it's really worth repairing it. Okay, and I'm just going to bung that in there. Now, might just eat that before it goes off on me. Okay, so we've got one energy brew at least, because one thing I do find is when you're in the snowy biome, I have terrible problems. Once my health starts going down, it just keeps going down. Obviously, that in there as well. Obviously our new armor should help somewhat with that. I'm going to get a couple of eggs. I find they're the best travel food because they don't go off very readily at all. And free of curry, boy have I been getting through a lot of that lately. I'm going to head off into the snowy biome again, and this time what I wanted to do, I have replaced my bedroll, but only with another sleeping bag just in case of disaster. And because I've got some actual beds, but I want to save those really for a proper base. So you can see why I wanted to keep my weight down, because my Carmen's still my favourite means of transport. I love flying, but also, yeah, she's the most efficient way of getting about, really. Trouble is, she's not much of a cargo craft. She can't carry that much weight. I have put a few of her level points into weight carriage, but I also want to give her health and melee damage and things. As I say, she's been my best companion when it comes to mammoth hunting, and she can really take down a mammoth. It takes her a while, but the mammoth can't really touch her, which is quite cool, really. So I'm going to carry on leveling her up. But yeah, the plan now, I think, is to find a location, a likely location, not too far from the border, because I want to be able to sort of grab resources and things. And there's quite a lot of trees over there, I suppose, but until we see how we're going to survive with our new armor on, I don't know. I'm going to sort of play it by ear a little bit, but I want to find a place where it looks relatively safe to build a base. Interesting developments in the game recently, I have noticed, and I don't know if this is a result of my level, because I'm now level 38, so approaching level 40. There's a hell of a lot more raptors around. You see there's a carnosaur down there, and then there's a T-Rex who's been going around sort of trashing trees and generally eating everything in sight. And I'm not quite sure why either of those ones has a red cloud going around them. I'm not sure if they're sort of going to gas me to death or sort of chomp on me, really. But there's a lot less dinos around here than there used to be, thanks to those guys. But the other thing I've noticed is that... And in fact, you see an example of that just over here. Some of there were a pack of them, but they've kind of died now. Some of the predators have started hunting in packs. There's a carnosaur there hunting a stego, but there's one only. Oh, no, there they go. There they go. There's a whole pack of saber-tooth attacking those stegos, and I've seen a lot of that recently. A pack of dire wolves. I've seen a pack of saber-tooths attacking Arcaviensis, and there's a couple of them at it down there right now. Pack of velociraptors attacking, I think it was an ankylosaur, and a pack of direwolves attacking a pair of mammoths. And the mammoths actually had the best of it, and oops, we better eat this. And they actually won out in the end, which was good for me, because that meant that I ended up then... running in there and grabbing all their pelts, which certainly helped towards the cause. Okay, so there's a few huge raptors over here as well. In fact, there's a blooming dead mammoth there or something. They've eaten it, unfortunately, but there's some direwolves. And you can see that this is very close to where I'd actually just placed... There goes another mammoth. This is actually very close to where I just placed my base, thinking that that was going to be a safe place. Really not sure it is, because all of a sudden there's all this stuff around here. I'm just going to go down here, but oh no, it's despawned. Actually, it's not despawned, it's been eaten by the direwolves. Okay, I have actually killed a direwolf myself and an Arcaviensis by this point, because they attacked me, so I didn't have much choice. And there's a T-Rex chasing a deer, and one of those huge mega whatever it is, elk. Mega elk, that's basically what they are. So what we want, really, is somewhere that's going to be safe enough that we are safe from all of these predators that are around. There's a truckload of them. I mean, Arcaviensis, that could be, you know, on a hide to nothing, trying to find somewhere safe from those guys, perhaps. But I'm looking at this ledge here and wondering if maybe that isn't a good plan. Looks like that's going to stay relatively free of aggro. I mean, obviously there's a big vulture guy over there, but we're certainly going to check this out. It's not very big, but I'm not actually planning on building an absolutely mega uber base around here. I more like want something that's going to be vaguely safe. And there does seem to be a lot of very dangerous wildlife. I mean, there's some good resources around here too, but so that is definitely a possibility. Let's just take a look up here. There's more space up here, and obviously there's this great big ledge thing as well, but I'm a bit concerned as well about accessibility. It is in my game plan, literally, to grab myself a big feathery friend as soon as possible, and that is going to be my choice of transport, I think. Which means that maybe, possibly, this ledge is going to be the best way to go. And then, because I'm not planning on spending like all my time here, it'd just be useful to have somewhere to stay when I'm doing my loot runs. Into the frozen forest, the frozen biome or whatever. So yeah, that ledge might be the way to go to at least establish a small base, and then if we want to build a bigger one, then we can do. But yeah, that would be very much accessible by sort of... they've killed off all those mammoths. Wow. You can see my two little bases here. There's one there and one there, and neither one of them looks ever so safe at the moment. That one's surrounded by direwolves, and this one over here has a T-Rex very, very close to it, and there's another T-Rex right over there. So all of a sudden I'm thinking that the ledge is a very good idea indeed. So there we go. So I'm going to just check out a little bit more of this is quite a slow mount as well, which is the other thing. I haven't really put speed into her. The thing is, you kind of have to I suppose you have to choose, as you do with yourself, where it's most expedient to put your points and their leveling points, and it's not always easy to make that choice. So I'm going to need to keep harvesting pelt from these hairballs, because every time I need to repair my fluffy armour, which I'm saying I like the look of it, I mean it is pretty fab looking, if I do say so myself, but yeah, I'm going to need to keep that in good repair as well. So, and it's doing a good job. I'm only feeling cold here, not absolutely freezing like I was before, and my health is staying stable, it's not going down. So I could fancy a dire wolf pet as well, I suppose, and that would be equally transferable into the rest of the map. Ultimately, I suppose I'd like to make a base that was, you know, a long way inland, or, you know, up that mountain or something. I think it's a volcano, this one, actually, but it would be cool to be able to do that. But I have a feeling I'm gonna have to put a bit of time into getting myself something faster for that. I like to travel by air, as I say. We'll head back for base now. I like to travel by air, but it's not so easy when your mount moves quite slowly. Okay, so I'm just wondering, there's some rocks around here which are really, really good for gathering oil. Trouble being, of course, that there is a T-Rex right there. And of course I'm also wondering whether, oh look, he's right there. I mean, really, this is a suicide mission. He's fighting something at the moment, but for how long, you know? Plus there's another T-Rex right over there. I mean, am I suicidal or what? I just want to see if our, there we go, 3, 7, 11, 13 oil. Yeah, that's pretty good, actually. And then how do we do with crystal? Only 2. Okay, that's a bit rubbish. But I don't want to spend too much time, yeah, flirting with danger. Let's see. I don't know who he's fighting or what he's fighting, but that, whoa, did he go down? That is incredible. What on earth kills a raptor, a rex like that? And do I want to mess? Not really, to be honest. That must have been more than one direwolf. There's no way one direwolf could do that. Whoa! Crap, here we go. He's woofing at me. I killed him. You see, now, what is going on there? We're going to have your pelt, pal. We are literally having your hide. There we go. Okay, so that was fun. Nice to see Carmen came to my rescue, even though she wasn't on follow. But I think it's definitely time to leave now. Okay, if you can still fly, Carmen. All right, here we go. So, yeah, that was fun. Getting attacked by a direwolf. But yeah, I'm not quite sure how the direwolf managed to bring down that Rex, given that I suppose it was already injured when I attacked it. You defecated. No, I did that. Did that a minute ago, actually. That Rex looks like he might be a little bit stuck in the water. Okay, so I'm just doing my best to avoid these budgerigars, because they look so cool. There are so many of them, though. I think the higher level dinos do kind of increase in number as you get higher level yourself, which makes sense. We still want the game to be challenging. And I don't feel like, having done a little bit, you're cold, really? I don't think so. I don't feel like having upped my harvesting settings. I don't actually feel like I'm OP now. I don't feel like I've got too much stuff there. I mean, I got 27 oil out of that and a cooked 2 crystal, that's all. So it's not like I got loads. And look at that armor. How ace is that? I look like an Eskimo. I suppose that I probably should change back now, because feet. Yeah. Well, can I just double click to do that? I just don't want to risk dropping anything on the ground because that would be stupid. All right, I'm just watching my bird's stamina here as well. I think with these pteranodons, you really do need to put quite a lot of points into their stamina, because otherwise you just risk falling straight out of the air on them. And quite often, if I do a long trip, I have to stop and rest, because otherwise she'll just fall straight out of the air. And I think that's going to happen this time as well, because we're a little bit heavily laden. Home sweet home. Okay, there we go. We've got quite a lot of dinos living on the beach down there, including at least one bronto, and I still have a goal in mind of having enough raptor force behind me, be it actual velociraptor or the smaller raptors, the form of dilos or whatever, to take out one of those things, because they really bug me, actually. They just trash all the trees. I don't think it's very realistic, because if they really were eating the trees, they wouldn't smack them all to bits. They wouldn't just stamp on them all, because if they did that, they'd starve to death. So I find that quite annoying mechanic, actually. Okay, so we've got a load of stuff here, including some stuff that's just totally broken. Like my hat, which is always totally broken, because... yeah, we're just gonna have to repair that, but we're gonna have to replace it more than anything else there. I got 2 pelt, whoopee doo. So not particularly a lot of pelt there. We've got some crystal and stuff, which I'll put elsewhere. But I won't repair those. I do need to repair this. I've probably got what I need in there to repair that. So I tend to use my workbench for repairing stuff, because it's got everything in there that I need. I tend to use it to repair stuff, even when I don't technically need it. Okay, so what have I got? I've got other stuff to put away. Did I put my crystal in there? No, there. Bear with me. Now I have. Okay, anything else? Well, we've got some oil, and for some reason I took my narcotic with me, which I didn't need to do, so put that away as well. And we've got oil now. This is the fridge over here that I've got my oil in to make myself some meat, cook some jerky. And you can see I've got 26 cooked meat jerky, which is pretty damn cool. I've also got 7 prime meat jerky, which, considering how fast the stuff actually rots down, prime meat is quite something, actually. And then I'm not sure if I really want to be carrying this gear around with me all the time. So I'm wondering whether I shouldn't have, not in there, whether I shouldn't have some sort of storage box upstairs for the like. Let's see, do I have any left? I think I've run out, but I can make a new one. I don't think we've got, see, I've got this. I don't know if we'll fit all this in. We might, actually. There we go, marvellous. And there we go, and so I've got my fur armour now, bar the hat. Or Nilklim or Barta, yeah. That would spring to mind. That's local to me. No one else is going to know what I'm talking about. Okay, so there we go. So we need some more egrams. You can see I'm not that far off, actually, being able to craft my hat, or be able to learn the recipe for that, at least. I'd quite like to learn the recipe for chairs and be able to sit down. I'm a bit of an immersion junkie, but at the same time, do I really need to do that? No, I don't really need to do that. A painting might be quite cool to be able to do, but again, it's kind of a luxury thing that I probably can't really afford, because I need to save my engrams for the stuff I really need. Bug repellent, well, I'm not that bothered by bugs. So yeah, I want to learn the bits so I can make an entire base out of stone. I want to learn the metal bits for the same reason I want to be able to make an entire base out of metal. I'll probably not want to make any of the firearms, so that'll save me a few engram points. I might learn a large crop plot, but I'm not quite sure what the benefit of that would actually be. And it looks like we've got some more armour coming up as well. I'm sure at some point I'll learn the engrams for metal armour, and given that you can go all the way down here to level 90, I have got a long way to go. But you never know. Now that I've put my harvesting drops rates up, we might actually get there, because I won't have to spend all my time chopping wood and mining for stone and gathering meat for my carnivorous dinos. At least that is my sincere hope. So as evening draws in, I will leave you guys. This episode has been long enough, I think, and in the next episode, who knows, I think probably we're going to start building a base over there in the snowy biome. I'm probably not going to be able to do it ever so fast, because we might even need, before we do anything else, to get ourselves another flyer. Because, oh hello Carmen, have you leveled up? That's excellent. Let's just do that to start off with. I don't think you need that, do you? So we'll take that off you. She's got enough meat on her, but it all tends to go off at once. So we've got health of 556. She's level, what is she, level 20 now? Level 19, she'll be level 20. Oxygen, food, weight, melee damage, movement, speed. Her speed's pretty slow, but really you need to put quite a bit of stamina into these guys. So there we go. So yeah, what I'm thinking is maybe next episode what we'll do is we'll go and we'll catch ourselves an Arcaviensis, and then we'll have two flyers, and even if I'm riding Carmen rather than the vulture, we can then load up the vulture with some stuff, and that way we could go and build a base on top of that ridge over there. It might still take quite a few trips to do it, because we're going to need stone to, you know, I want to make it out of stone basically at this point. And that's another argument, of course, for not making it very big. It might not even be as big as this one, but basically we just need to get a relatively small base established first, and then get, maybe we can expand it outwards to, you know, take up most of the ledge or whatever. But yeah, so that's what I think we'll do next time. We'll see if we can get ourselves a feathered friend, so I'll look into that and just make sure that I'm actually going to be able to, I won't necessarily need to ride it, we could use it as a beast of burden to start with. Poor enslaved dinosaurs. In the meantime, well, at least if they belong to me, they're slightly less likely to get eaten by, you know, one of those raptors over there, because that's the other thing we have to contend with now. More and more raptors, oh my. So guys, thank you very much for watching. Hit the like button if you liked the episode. Don't forget to leave a comment if you want to. Think about subscribing if you haven't already. Check out my other episodes. I've done quite a few ARK episodes now, but I like to do lots of other survival stuff as well. Hopefully I will be able to carry on this series now without too much difficulty. Nonetheless, I will probably start another series soon, a different survival game, so watch out for that. I'll be putting something on about on my Twitter feed and what have you anyway. So till I see you in the next episode or in another video, guys, keep gaming, keep smiling, and bye-bye for now.